In the Hall of Fame of Ranch Cooks, there's a name you'll never hear. We had him at the Bar V for a while. In truth, I guess he could have made the 10 most wanted list because poisoning cowboys really was his style. I remember one October, we were at the Tanner camp. He'd cooked a pot of chili, make you sweat. Well, it was really pretty tasty, but then later on that night, we sounded like a bullfrog bass quartet. That next morning, something happened that had put him in a funk. I think he thought we'd eaten his sardines. We were hoping for some biscuits, maybe even sourdough, but he heated up that mess of chili beans. It was just a little thicker, and by lunch that afternoon, it had a crust, just like a cherry pie, only crunchier and gritty, like an asphalt shingle is. We ate it, but it made young Milty cry. After supper, he served chili. "That's all you get," he said, then wiped a tar-like substance from his beard. An image of La Brea came to mind as I dug in. My spoon broke off and slowly disappeared. But that evening in the bunkhouse, it was like a battlefield. Blankets billowed with each unexpected round, huge explosions, whistling tracers, not to mention SBDs, but nowhere was a gas mask to be found. Breakfast came. We had more chili. He reheated it again. It concentrated down like toxic waste. Our old bellies were rebelling as he chipped us out a chunk. It left a sort of diesel aftertaste. Gus had found a box of ear tags, so that's what we had for lunch. But supper brought no edible release, because he served a chili cinder block. It was standing on all fours. He hacksawed off each one of us a piece. So that night in desperation, we convened to make a plan. Shoot the cook, drag his entrails through the fire. But we realized that wouldn't work. The chili would live on. Complete destruction was what we'd require. That next morning found us gathered at the Eastside cookhouse door with pitchforks, shotguns, bayonets, and spears. Bob had found a propane burner and a couple carbide guns. We charged the kitchen like the Grenadiers. Total chaos, immolation. Not a pan or plate survived. The walls caved in. The trusses all were bared, but still standing in the ruins. Like Godzilla with a gout, the chili demon growled at us and glared. "I can't take it," cried old Jimbo, his machete o'er his head. He hacked it into little greasy specks. The cook watched the execution. Then Jim turned to him and said, "You fix us something good, or Bud, you're next." We had two more days of cow work, and we ate like we were kings. But that cook's concoction still gives me the shakes. It's come back to haunt me daily. Been recycled, don't you see? I smell chili every time I hit the brakes.